Everything new in Kapwing broadcasts directly to you, the creator. This is your Kapwing Direct.
Hey everyone, this is Grace from Kapwing, and since the last Kapwing Direct, we have rolled out a ton of changes that will help you effectively tell your stories. These most recent enhancements and added features have made Kapwing more powerful than ever and will improve every part of your creative workflow, from finding and uploading content, to editing in the timeline, to adjusting the appearance of things like subtitles, text, audio. And in this video, I'm gonna go over all these changes and show you how you can use them to make better videos. If you have any feedback or suggestions on how we can further improve Kapwing after you try out these new features, let us know in the comments below. You can also give your feedback directly to me and other Team Kapwing members by joining our Discord server. Now get to Kapwing by clicking the first link below and let's go try out these new features together. So the first thing you'll probably notice when you get to Kapwing Studio now is that the layout is a little bit different. Instead of having the top bar here with the options for adding different elements to your project, we have it on the left side here, and we did this to make it more condensed and simplified and give the studio an overall cleaner look. For now, the upload and subtitles buttons are still in the top in the middle of the screen. Now, in terms of uploading and adding assets onto the canvas in the timeline, we have a new feature called the Media Library, which you can see on the left side here, and it's the first tab. This is basically where all your different assets that you've used across your workspace are stored. So if you made other projects that have videos, images, and GIFs, they will all appear here and you can scroll through them, even audio files. This is to make it easier to just see all your files in one place, and especially if you use things repeatedly across your projects, you don't have to constantly re-upload them every time you make a new one. It also provides a space to organize your files before you actually try and add them to the timeline and time them out. So for example, when I make a video, I first start by uploading all my files to this space, and then I can see which ones I want to add in what order. You'll have the All Media, which is all your files across your workspace, but then you also have a tab called This Project, and that's if you want to isolate just a few files that you're only going to use in this project into one space. If you want to add something from the media library to your project, all you have to do is roll over it, click the plus, and it will be added onto the canvas. So since this is an image, it doesn't bring up the timeline, but if I did add something like a video, by clicking the plus, it would come onto the canvas as well and then show up in the timeline. Now, if you're looking for stock photos, videos, GIFs, or GIF text animations that you want to add to your project, you might want to take a look at our plugins tab. We launched plugins with a few of our beta partners, such as Unsplash, Giphy, and Pexels and Pixabay, and you'll find them all in the left side here with the plugins icon. If you click on any one of these boxes, it'll pull up a window where you can search. Unsplash will find stock photos for you, and these are all completely license-free, easy to use. You can just click one and it'll bring it into your project. The same goes for Pexels, which is videos and images, and then Pixabay is also stock images. Giphy Search will find you some cool GIFs to use, and then the Giphy Text plugin will create different styles of text, animated text GIFs, from whatever phrase you put in. Now, once you have a couple layers on the canvas in the timeline, sometimes you might want to select multiple of them at one time and do different things with them. And now that is possible. Select multiple layers just by dragging. You can do this on the canvas or in the timeline. So if I just click and drag, you can see that the outlines and the little purple dots in the corners will light up on the layers that I've selected. So if I only drag this much, make that little square and let go, it will select those two layers and I can drag them around the canvas without anything else moving. I can also resize both of them by clicking the purple dots in the corner. You can see that both layers are resizing as I drag. You can also multi-select in the timeline by dragging as well. If I click and drag over the layers I want to select, you'll see that the white outline appears on the layers that are selected. So dragging a box this size and letting go selects these two layers, and then I can move them at the same time to wherever I want in the timeline and even put them at the end or beginning of other layers. Another way to multi-select is just to click and hold down the shift key on your keyboard and then click the other layers you want to select. We've also added some functionality to the timeline rows so you can organize your timeline to your liking. You'll see on the left side here, the rows now have numbers and you can rearrange them too. So if you see this hand icon and click the row number, the whole row will be selected and you can drag it to wherever you want relative to the other layers. You can also delete or add rows. So to do that, you can click the row number you want to add or delete to, and then right click and then click add row above or delete row. So add row above would make a new one, and then delete row would take away one. You can also add content directly to a specified row by clicking the row you want to add content to. And you'll see that this whole row is now selected. There's this lighter shading. So when you do add content, whether it's text or images or other assets, it will add it to that specific row. Now, in terms of actually trimming, splitting, and editing your clips in the timeline, one new feature that we've added is ripple mode. The default for the timeline right now in Kapwing is that spaces are left when you delete different clips. So for example, if I were to split this clip in the middle and delete this middle portion, a space is automatically left. And if I wanted to delete that portion, I would also have to click it and click delete. With ripple mode, the clips essentially will move together and not allow any new gaps be created. Although it does preserve gaps that are made before you turn ripple mode on. To turn ripple mode on, you click this icon here. And then if I were to split again in the middle of this clip now and delete this portion, the whole timeline moves down so that it doesn't leave any gap and it still preserves this existing gap that happened before I turned ripple mode on. We added ripple mode to accommodate different preferences for how people edit video. Sometimes people want to have the customizability of having these gaps be left so they can add new content in later on, but other times people want to just cut different parts out and have no gaps be created. And you can toggle ripple mode on or off just by clicking this button here. Another mode that you can turn on or off when you're working in the timeline is snapping. Snapping is automatically on when you start using Kapwing Studio, and it's indicated by this icon here. So it's purple, meaning it's on. Snapping is helpful to ensure that layers come onto the screen or disappear at the exact same time as other layers around it, but sometimes you want more flexibility with that. So for example, if I wanted this video clip to end at the same exact time as this layer down here, I could drag the layer and it will snap to that exact time where the text stops. That one showed that they're leaving the screen at the same time. But if I wanted to stagger it, so I don't want it to happen at the same time, I can turn snapping off and now I can move it and make really precise increments without being forced to stay to the exact length of the other layers. So for example, in this one, my video will end a little bit earlier than the text layer, as we can see here. Now, as you increase the amount of layers in your project, organizing those layers and understanding which one's which becomes more important. And to do that, you can use the Layers tab. This lists out every single layer in your video, including videos, text, GIFs, images, and now you can rename them. You can do this just by double-clicking the layer name, and then you can add in your own text. Subtitles is another feature that is very frequently used in Kapwing, and there's a new way to edit subtitles now. So as usual, if you want to add subtitles, you can go to the top bar and auto-generate them, as I'm gonna do here. You will still need to adjust how they appear on the screen in this window here. For example, changing the fonts and the size. But instead of having to fiddle with when the subtitles appear on the screen in this window here by adjusting these bars, if you click done, you'll notice that there is a row in the timeline for the subtitles, and you can do all of that adjusting here. So I can click and drag to extend subtitles, I can move them around to different sections, I can even split them and adjust as needed. This is especially helpful for lining up the subtitles and when they appear on screen relative to the other layers in your project. You also have greater control with volume adjusting and audio with these new updates. You've probably noticed that the volume of the different video clips is shown on the screen in the timeline, and there is a pink line that goes across the clip as well. That will allow you to adjust the volume of that clip. You can make it lower, but you can now also make it higher, up to 200% of the original volume, which is a new feature. So to do that, you can just click the little pink line and drag it up or down, and it reflects the percentage change. You can also do this by clicking the clip and then going onto the right side here and in the Edit tab and increasing the volume slider or decreasing it. In addition to that, a highly requested feature was the ability to fade audio in and out. And you can do that here with pure audio clips, but also with video clips now. Fading in and out is great to transition different sounds. I'm gonna try adding fade in and out to this video clip here. To do that, you can click it and then go to the effects tab on the right side, click fade. And now you have the option to add it to the intro, outro, or both, and have it be slow or the default or fast speed. So for example, you can see now that the intro clip is a little bit lower at the start. If I add it to both, you can see that the end is also decreased. Some other things to be aware of are the new text appearance options that you have to customize your text a little further. If you go to the text tab, you'll first notice that there are different sizes that you can automatically add to your project, such as header versus large versus default. You can even choose decorated or other types of fonts directly here without having to search through the font options. There are two other new things you can do with the appearance of text. One is change the opacity. You can decrease it so it's more see-through. And then another thing you can do is blur text, and that effect will be in the effects tab by clicking blur. And you can adjust how blurred it is. We would love to hear what you think of these new features in addition to any others you want to see in Kapwing. Drop us a note in the comments below and join our Discord where you can talk to us directly. Make sure to subscribe to our channel so you can get further updates on Kapwing in the future, and we'll see you in the next video.